Welcome to the Advisory Science Channel. Today we're going to talk about the different states of matter. Everything around us is made of stuff called matter. This matter can be in different forms or states: solid, liquid, or gas. Things like seawater, the breeze, and even an umbrella are made of matter, but they are all very different. To work out the state of something, we need to look at a few things. These things are called properties. For example, does it have a shape that stays the same? What happens when we put it in a container? Can we squash it? Let's start with solids. Examples of solids are rocks, metal, and ice. A solid has a fixed shape which does not change unless a force is used to change it. Solids do not change shape when placed in a container. Now, let's talk about liquids. Water, milk, and blood are examples of liquids. Liquids do not have their own shape. They flow and take the shape of whatever container they're poured into. Next up are gases. Some common gases are oxygen, carbon dioxide, and water vapor. The thing about gases is that many of them, like the air we breathe, are invisible, so we can't see them even though they're all around us. Gases don't have a fixed shape and spread out to fill their container. If there's no lid or cover, they escape. Unfortunately, some human behaviours have increased the amount of gases in the air, leading to pollution, which is bad for our health and our planet. Another property of solids, liquids, and gases is whether they can be easily squashed. It's very difficult to squash solids. It's very difficult to squash liquids, but it's easy to squash gases. Now, let's talk about some tricky substances, like sand. Pour sand and it flows like a liquid, but each grain of sand is solid. Similarly, sponges and Play-Doh are solids, but they're easy to squash. Why do you think this is? That's all for today. Remember to think about the properties of matter next time you see something interesting. Bye for now.
Thanks for watching. For more science resources, visit our website, advisoryscience.com, and check out the blog for even more educational content. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay updated on our latest episodes.